Hey, Daddy, I want a golden goose.
Here we go again.
All right, sweetheart, all right. Daddy will get you a golden goose as soon as we get home.
No, I want one of those.
Bunker, how much do you want for the golden goose?
They're not for sale.
Name your price.
She can't have one.
Who says I can't?
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Dennis Prager Show. I am in Washington, D.C. Thank you to Hillsdale College, their great Kirby Center here in Washington, D.C., putting me up and giving me this lovely studio. By the way, you can't get a more gorgeous day than the day today in Washington, D.C., I have to say. Hey, everybody, have you seen the conservative and right-wing rioters over the Kate Steinle verdict? Tearing down stores and overturning vehicles and closing highways and bridges in the Bay Area. Did you see the coverage of that? You didn't? Wow. You mean you're kidding me. There are no right-wing riots taking place? Oh, yeah, I forgot. Conservatives don't riot. Of course. How did I forget that? Can you imagine if it were a case? Well, you don't have to imagine. We all know about the rioting after jury cases that offended people on the left. The people murdered, the people maimed, the stores burned down, and the bridges closed, and the highways shut, the cars overturned. That only happens on the left. The moral chasm between left and right is so gigantic that I'm not sure that it can be even called a cavern. It's an ocean that separates the morality of left and right. Not liberals. I always make that point because the point needs to be made. Liberals are not leftists. They don't know it, but they're not. They don't know it. That's the tragedy. They still think that they have to fight conservatives when the left is the one that's threatening Western civilization. But just think about it now. Next time you see another riot on the part of left-wingers, whether it's at a campus or at a bridge, tunnel, highway, stores, department stores, you name it, just ask, when was the last conservative riot? It's really tough to recall, isn't it? How come conservatives don't riot? You think conservatives are happy with the Steinle verdict about this illegal? By the way, this illegal immigrant who was, I think, deported 5 or 6 times from the United States back to Mexico, came back every time. And the city of San Francisco, which considers itself moral, as all the leftists do, it's a self-pleasure term for the left. They think they're progressive and kind and compassionate and pro-science and all these wonderful things. And they're none of those things. And so they have this self-image that that facts never interfere with. But imagine this case. Who is responsible for Kate Steinle's death? City of San Francisco, which refused to give up this, give this man to federal authorities. Deported 5, 6 times. Didn't matter. Had arrests. Didn't matter. Deported. Remember, deported. I don't disagree with the verdict, incidentally. I don't know everything. I didn't follow the case avidly. I didn't read the transcript, but from what I read in reports, the defense contended, and it seemed to me to be plausible, that the bullet hit concrete and ricocheted staggeringly, unhappily, and tragically with one shot ripped into Kate Steinle's aorta, and she died. And if that is the case, then it was not intentional. He didn't aim it at her. But, of course, she'd be alive if it weren't for San Francisco. San Francisco is more at fault than even the guy himself. That's the amazing thing. But they don't take blame because, remember, one of the mottos of the left is being on the left means never having to say you're sorry. The task of a leftist is to feel good about himself. I'm for the poor. I'm for the underdog. I'm for the marginalized. I love the terms they come up with. The disenfranchised, the minority, you name it. I don't think morally. I think in terms of power and weak, West and East, black and white, etc. So, no riots. No riots were there.